Sebulan lebih perang Israel-Hamas, Presiden Joko Widodo juga akan menyampaikan solusi damai dari hasil KTT OKI dalam pertemuan dengan Presiden Amerika Serikat Joe Biden pekan depan. Soal desakan gencatan senjata yang belum terwujud, Duta Besar Amerika Serikat menyebut Presiden Biden menekankan jeda kemanusiaan. Lengkapnya dalam ulasan Istana bersama jurnalis Kompas TV Friska Clarissa.
Dari hasil OKI nanti, saya akan diutus untuk menyampaikan kepada Presiden Joe Biden agar perang di Hamas Israel bisa segera di stop.
To the humanitarian issues and rights, how does the US see this and what will be the solution to bring back peace, to stop the war, and save the innocent civilians?
Then Secretary Blinken and others have spoken about this in great detail, deeply concerned about the well-being of the Palestinian people.
Indonesia menegaskan posisi berdiri bersama Palestina. Pemerintah bersama berbagai elemen masyarakat bahu-membahu mengirimkan bantuan bagi warga Palestina yang jadi korban, serta tegas mengutuk dan mendorong segera dihentikannya serangan Israel ke Gaza. Aksi bela Palestina lintas agama pun digelar. Bagaimana Indonesia bisa memaksimalkan peran dalam mendorong segera dihentikannya bombardir Israel ke Gaza? Lengkapnya dalam ulasan Istana bersama saya, Friska Clarissa.
Lewat sebulan, perang Israel-Hamas belum berhenti. Gaza, Palestina makin luluh lantak dibombardir Israel. 10.000 lebih nyawa warga sipil Palestina terenggut dan kemungkinan terus bertambah jika serangan tak kunjung berakhir. Indonesia menegaskan posisi berdiri bersama Palestina. Masyarakat berbondong-bondong menyerukan dukungan lewat aksi bela Palestina lintas agama. Pemerintah, TNI Polri, dan berbagai elemen masyarakat mengirim bantuan kemanusiaan tahap pertama berisi 51,5 ton yang terdiri dari bahan makanan, alat medis, selimut, tenda, dan barang-barang logistik lain. Bantuan ini dibawa ke Gaza melalui Mesir dan akan pula dibuka tahap berikutnya. Lewat jalur diplomasi, Indonesia lewat Menteri Luar Negeri Retno Marsudi lantang bersuara mendorong gencatan senjata di Gaza dan mewujudkan kemerdekaan Palestina di berbagai forum, termasuk Perserikatan Bangsa-Bangsa. Selain itu, pasca menghadiri KTT luar biasa OKI terkait krisis kemanusiaan di Gaza, 12 November, Presiden Jokowi juga akan bertemu Presiden Amerika Serikat Joe Biden di Gedung Putih Washington DC untuk menyampaikan pesan agar perang antara Israel dan Hamas bisa segera dihentikan.
Dari hasil OKI nanti, saya akan diutus untuk menyampaikan kepada Presiden Joe Biden agar perang di Hamas Israel bisa segera di stop, bisa di segera dihentikan.
Di tengah desakan berbagai negara untuk gencatan senjata, Israel menolak mentah-mentah usulan itu. Sementara dalam wawancara dengan Duta Besar Amerika Serikat untuk Indonesia, Sung Yong Kim, sikap Amerika Serikat seperti yang disampaikan Presiden AS Joe Biden mencoba memfasilitasi jeda kemanusiaan untuk mengalirkan bantuan kemanusiaan bagi rakyat Palestina yang membutuhkan di Gaza.
According to this global stability challenges, Indonesia through the OIC and in front of the United Nations urge the realization of an immediate ceasefire in Gaza to stop more civilians casualties. And recently, President Joko Widodo emphasized that Indonesia is extremely angry and strongly condemns Israel's random attacks against civilians facilities in Gaza. Due to the humanitarian issues and rights, how does the U.S. see this and what will be the solution to bring back peace, to stop the war and save the innocent civilians?
Yeah, first of all, let me say we're deeply concerned about the humanitarian crisis in Gaza. Yeah. President Biden, Secretary Blinken and others have spoken about this in great detail, deeply concerned about the well-being of the Palestinian people. And this is why we're working so hard with Israel, with Egypt, with relevant UN agencies and other partners to try to facilitate a sustainable flow of humanitarian assistance to the Palestinian people in need in Gaza, and that effort will continue. I should note that the U.S. has long been the largest donor to the Palestinian people, and that will continue as well. That said, I think we can agree that terrorism is unacceptable, and we should condemn terrorism when it happens. In regards to any type of pause, I would refer you to what President Biden said just recently about the importance of thinking about humanitarian pauses to allow for the flow of humanitarian assistance.
So it will be possible to do?
Well, I think we're going to do everything possible to help the Palestinian people in Gaza to make sure that they receive the humanitarian assistance they need, and that the humanitarian assistance that we're sending is not diverted to Hamas. And so it's a complicated situation, as you know. So we'll have to work very closely with our partners there, including Egypt, Israel, and UN agencies, to make sure that the assistance is going to the people who need it.
So still the priority is for the civilians
absolutely, in Gaza. Absolutely, yes. Mm-hmm.
You know that Indonesia's government stands with Palestine alongside with the support from Indonesian people through several rallies and demonstrations in Indonesia. As the U.S. ambassador, how would you explain this situation to the President of the United States?
So I think one of the great things about Indonesia is that it's a democracy. People have a right to speak their concerns. People have a right to gather and hold protests. So my office actually overlooks the area where they have been holding protests, and I've been impressed by just how orderly and peaceful these demonstrations have been. And I appreciate cooperation that we're getting from the Indonesian law enforcement agencies here. But, you know, people have a right to speak and share their concerns publicly, and I respect their right.
Tak ada lagi tempat aman di Gaza. Bahkan mobil pembawa bantuan, ambulans, dan rumah sakit turut jadi sasaran Israel. Demi kemanusiaan, warga dunia terus menyerukan perang dihentikan agar warga sipil mendapatkan hak hidup dan menghentikan derita warga Palestina.
Indonesia berdiri membela kemerdekaan Palestina sebagai bentuk perjuangan kemanusiaan serta bagian amanat konstitusi. Melaksanakan ketertiban dunia yang berdasarkan kemerdekaan, perdamaian abadi, dan keadilan sosial. Friska Clarissa, Bimo Wicaksana, Kompas TV, Jakarta.